Foreign aid has certainly not been a failure in all respects. In this lecture, I just want to give a few examples of foreign aid that really has worked well. Perhaps the most successful example of foreign aid is the Green Revolution. This is both a scientific and a political triumph. On the science side, beginning with Norman Borlaug, working with the aid of the Rockefeller Foundation in Mexico to develop through cross-fertilization new superior agricultural varieties of plants, which were much more productive, higher yielding wheat, higher yielding rice. Combined with the proper use of fertilizer and pesticides, these techniques meant that a billion people who quite likely would have died were able to live. On the political side, these ideas were adopted with the help of the Ford Foundation, brought to India with the help of people like Chidambaram Subramaniam. Chidambaram Subramaniam was India's Minister of Food and Agriculture, and acting as a political entrepreneur, he was able to overcome opposition to these new ideas and very quickly have them spread throughout India, saving hundreds and hundreds of millions of people. This is the Green Revolution. Ford Foundation, Rockefeller Foundation were extremely important in making it happen. An important point to keep in mind is that aid can reduce suffering and death and dying even without increasing growth. Aid can help people without increasing growth. Some simple examples, oral rehydration therapy has saved many children from dying of diarrhea. Vaccines have saved many children. When you save a child with oral rehydration therapy, mechanically that reduces GDP per capita, but it makes the parents better off, it makes the child better off, doesn't make anyone else worse off, so this is definitely a case where aid can help. Another recent example is the spread of bed nets to reduce malaria in Africa. So in Kenya between 2003 and 2008, the fraction of households owning at least one insecticide-treated bed net increased from just 8.3% to 61%, almost 61%, in just 5 years. At the same time, Kenya's rate of post-neonatal deaths, deaths under age 5, they dropped by more than half. Now, other things were going on at the same time, including higher GDP per capita, better water supplies, better health infrastructure. But it's been estimated that half of the drop in post-neonatal death was explained by the spread of bed nets alone. Now, it's interesting to point out that these characteristics of successful foreign aid efforts have a few things in common. So think about oral rehydration therapy, vaccines, and bed nets. One thing they have in common is they're all quite cheap. That means that there's not a lot of point in stealing oral rehydration therapy. It's not worth it. Not a lot of ways you could be corrupt there. And they also involve a lot of self-help. So oral rehydration therapy was really just going door to door, explaining to mothers how to create the combination of fluids, a little bit of salt, a little bit of sugar, and how to give it to their children. And that alone saved millions of lives. So these cheap, readily available in poor countries, not a lot of investment required, and self-help, all of these things really were effective. Finally, it would be remiss of me not to mention the greatest anti-poverty program ever, which is immigration. Bringing immigrants from Haiti to the United States, for example, is by far the most cost-effective and the most is going to have the most effect on raising people out of poverty. Just bringing somebody from Haiti to the United States, their income is probably going to go up by at least 10 times. Once they're here, many of them send back remittances to their home country, to their family in their home country. Remittances, you know, just like giving gifts, even to your family, have problems. But overall, remittances do appear to be more effective than straight foreign aid, perhaps because the givers do have better information about where the remittances can best be used, who can be trusted with them, and so forth. Remittances are massive. In 2011, remittances were in the range of almost $400 billion worldwide, which significantly exceeds all foreign aid combined. So immigration and remittances by far the best anti-poverty program ever. People often don't want to hear that, but that in fact is the truth. Thanks.